family's been an important voice for architecture for more than 50 years. He's an architect, an editor, a writer, an exhibition curator, and has his hands on a lot of different projects. He does that all in the service of making ideas public, of supporting the work of many different architects also working here in Chicago.
He thinks about the position that is best for architects to take, even if it's something very political or happening in the city or something that's being built or proposed. And he is not afraid to take a stand.
This is one of his most famous images, which is Crown Hall sinking into Lake Michigan. So this is Mies van der Rohe, who in a way was a mentor of Stanley's. And if you scratch the surface of Stanley, you're always going to find a sort of Miesian character there.
He shares that modernist gene, but he morphs it into something new. Stanley's architecture is always about telling a story, like the Illinois Holocaust Museum and Education Center, for example. He's trying to take that content and turn it into a narrative.
When he did the Holocaust, his main clientele that he felt, anyway, were the survivors.
He has a tremendous interest in social justice. There's a Jewish concept of repairing the world, tikkun olam. And I think he is interested in repairing the world.
I've always been compelled by the way Stanley uses architecture to improve everyday life for people and the human experience.
Certainly his work is visually beautiful, but it serves constituents. It makes lives better. It gives people something they didn't otherwise have. Pacific Garden Mission, for example, provides a place to sleep for maybe 1,000 people every night, and that Stanley would be sought after to solve the design challenges and goals of those organizations is, I think, a testament to how important his career is and to how good he is at it.
My co-artistic director, Joseph Grima, and I were inspired by a conference that Stanley Tigerman organized in 1977 called The State of the Art of Architecture. And we took the title for the inaugural Chicago Architecture Biennial from that conference because we wanted to do the same thing. He really just wants to see Chicago in the center of the conversation. He wants to see people doing things, to take risks, to invest in ideas, to invest in people that have ideas.
As a TV interviewer myself, I never pass up a chance to interview Stanley. He always gives you a good interview. You have to be ready to bleep a lot of words, but he always has an opinion and he is not shy about sharing it.
He's always an instigator and a leader, you know, and so in that sense, he's really kind of a mentor for me and someone who has such strong integrity that I really look up to as a human being as well.
He's often described as the conscience of the architecture community, making sure that the work is for the public good.
His opinion matters, and he's connected to architects all over the world. In many aspects and in many of his conversations, he's conducting the design dialogue on behalf of Chicago.
He'll always say, if you come to Chicago, there's a real history and love of architecture in this city.
There's no doubt that Chicago is in the canon of architecture. And I think that it's becoming a kind of center of the conversation again. And that's the work of people like Stanley that have worked to put Chicago on the map and keep it on the map.